something they had never done before in history. What you see right here, Dan, if you could move for a minute, move that sign with you. Right in there in that case in front of Jim are the little bitty robots. That's a mock-up of the robots. They're the first ones that went up, but they are so small in comparison to the new one up there. That was brought in with the 2004, brought in the museum by Dr. James Garvin, who's head of the program, head scientist out of Goddard in Maryland. Pearl and I were also taken at no expense for a two-day STEM workshop and tour the building and see what is it that they worked on there?
The telescope, Hubble.
The Hubble telescope, we're working on a new telescope there, so that was another exciting thing to do. But this is an amazing thing because in 2002, we opened the second floor thanks to Congressman, at that time, Sherry Bowler, who was a good friend of mine. He said to me, well, Marlene, I don't think they're going to find water on Mars. I said, yes, they will, Sherry. I bet you they will. And they have. So now they find water on Mars. They now know that life existed at one time. So the purpose of this is to see why life ceased to exist there and why that planet went dark and what they can learn from that will be helpful to our planet. I would like to now for a minute turn it over to Sarah Borman, who is representing Congressman Richard Hanna, and then to our council representative, Frank Becerra. Sarah?
Well, thank you so much for all you do for our community, and especially the youngest members and hopefully budding scientists in our community. This is just such a gem in our community, and it's so fitting too, because really, the science, technology, engineering, and math education that's just so imperative to living a successful and meaningful and sustainable life here these days. And it's really just so imperative. And so thank you for igniting that curiosity and all of the things that you're hearing.
Thank you. Thank you. Sir?
It's always a pleasure to be here. And I'm glad you invite me on these periodic periodic events, and I just can't wait for the next one. But it's so nice to see this is a very active museum, and you normally think a museum is not being very blown out, but not this one. We were just here just a few months ago, showing what solar panels can do, and we really appreciate your dedication and your bringing these fine things to you here. Thank you so much.
You're very welcome. Earl, would you pan around now, please, and get some shots of the kids? Actually, the kids don't spend too much time with us over there with these things. They're already, as you can see, standing over there putting together a micromagnet lab. And just now you're waiting for the government to help. He's just on his own doing it. And in the middle of the field, you'll be working on a microscope that gives